The Lockheed Martin F-35 Lightning II and Sukhoi Su-57 are both fifth-generation advanced stealth aircraft, designed and developed for the next-generation war. In a few minutes, we will show you which aircraft would come on top in different scenarios. Who is the best, the F-35 or the Su-57? First, let's take a quick look at the design characteristics and how they compare to each other. The F-35 is the U.S. government's one fighter-does-it-all solution considering the high cost of the F-20 to Raptor and multiple aircraft models the U.S. operates, which comes with logistical and financial burdens. While the F-22 remains the world's most lethal aircraft, the F-35 would be the workhorse, designed to be used by all services of the U.S. Armed Forces. Despite several serious problems, the F-35 without a doubt is an extremely capable, dangerous aircraft and has defeated all enemy threats in numerous war games. Russian Su-57 is the nation's entry to the fifth-generation fighter game, and it is a very impressive product for a nation developing its first true stealth aircraft. With India's withdrawal from the Su-57 agreement due to various design concerns, the program experienced serious financial problems. Russia's marketing campaign included the new fighter demonstrate its capabilities in Syrian theater in order to attract new potential buyers to revive the program. When Turkey was sanctioned by the U.S. for purchasing the Russian S-400 air defense system, Russia saw an opportunity to sell the Su-57 to Turkey, which would infuse a huge capital into the nearly dead program. In February 2021, Russia announced that the serial production began and first Su-57 was rolled out of the factory to be transferred to Russian Air Force. In terms of design characteristics, there are two big differences between the jets. While the F-35 is 51 feet long, the Su-57 is quite larger at a length of almost 70 feet. This allows the Su-57 to be able to carry more weapons internally and fly further than the F-35 with a range of 3,100 miles versus 1,380 miles. Both aircraft can also carry weapons on their wings, attached to their external hardpoints in a non-stealthy configuration in a scenario when air superiority is established, and there is no need to fly stealth. The Su-57 is a lot faster with a maximum speed of Mach 2 at high altitude compared to F-35's Mach 1.6. Thanks to its double-engine configuration, which provides more thrust and maneuverability to the Russian fighter. While the Su-57 has greater speed, it must make use of afterburners in order to fly at supersonic speeds due to the fourth-generation engines on currently built aircraft. Russia is developing the Isdalia 30 engines, which would provide fifth-generation advantages such as supercruise, meaning achieving supersonic speeds without the use of afterburners. However, the new engines would probably not be operational before 2025. The use of afterburners would nullify the Su-57's stealth abilities and make it visible to the radar, where F-35 would have a clear advantage to shoot the Su-57 from far away without being detected. Speaking of stealth, Su-57 has poor low observation capabilities. Its RCS or radar cross-section area is significantly worse at half a square meter compared to F-35's 0.001 square meters. For better understanding, the Su-57's head-on radar cross-section is the size of a truck tire, while the F-35's RCS is the size of a golf ball. With such a dramatic difference in stealth features, the F-35 would clearly be the winner in a head-on long-range engagement against a Su-57. With its high speed, large size, range and weapons, the Su-57 would have the upper hand in a dogfight. In fact, it would easily dominate the F-35. But in a real war scenario, a dogfight between US and Russian jets doesn't seem quite possible with the use of long-range sensors and missile systems. One option would be a hypothetical dogfight between a Turkish Su-57 and a Greek F-35 over the Aegean Sea. In such a scenario, Turkish Air Force would have a clear advantage against its Greek counterpart considering both air forces are constantly engaged in dogfights for decades. This would actually be another subject to cover for a future video on who would dominate the Aegean skies in a conflict with the inclusion of S-400 systems, Turkish drones, Greek Rafale fighters, surface and subsurface platforms, and the geography of the region. Well, let's get back to who wins, the Su-57 or F-35. With its high stealth features, fifth-generation engine and state-of-the-art avionics, the F-35 is the winner in most circumstances. However, the Su-57 gives the clear advantage to the Russians in close-quarter fights. One last indication on which aircraft is better may actually be the numbers of units already built. With over 625 F-35s in service versus a dozen Su-57s, the Lockheed Martin F-35 Lightning II is already on order book of more than 10 countries and in active service with several air and naval forces of U.S. allies. The Su-57's potential operators include Algeria, India, Brazil, Turkey, Iraq, and Vietnam. Tell us which aircraft you think is better by leaving a comment. Check out our other videos on our channel and please don't forget to subscribe. See you in our next video.